This is a guide on creating a dynamic LED fiber optic star display. I made dynamic star field infinity mirror art piece, but these instructions can also be used to make the dynamic star ceiling or a star or a static star display. The star have a wonderful pinpoint quality that can be programmed to display any color and animated to twinkle or pulse. Unlike other displays, I use an LED strip with custom attachment instead of typical fiber optics illuminator. With Arduino programming, the options are limitless for the triggers and animation. Advice: to test everything, this is especially important when you are working with new materials. For example, I tried 4 different adhesive for my optic fiber optics and ended up using hot glue, which still wasn't the best solution because I wouldn't wrap the fiber optics strands. Supplies: materials, Adrafib, Atro, MO Express, NeoPixel, RGBW strip, fiber optic strands, solders, wires, zip ties, hot glue, heat shrink, tools, 3D printer, something to make small hole in your material, soldering iron, hot glue gun. Step 1. Preparation. First, you need to decide how your star display will look and what will be in or on. I made frame for mine, but you could use any existing box, ceiling, etc. These display look best in the dark, so I recommend that it's somewhere that you can control the lighting and against a dark surface. Also a little bit of fiber optics goes a long way. I bought a 9.8 feet 300 piece bundle of strands, used about 2 or 3 of it, and wouldn't have been okay with 1/3. So take the time to do the math, so you make sure everything will fit in whatever you are housing your display in, because too many strands become a cable management nightmare. Step 2. Circuit diagram and code. Shown above is the basic circuit diagram for my build. My build is triggered by audio, but you can add a variety of triggers or sensors to trigger your strip animation. The NeoPixel strands test is a good place to start to decide what you want display. Step 3. 3D print LED strip clips for fiber optics. Fiber optics work by directing light through transmissive strands. This works with any visible light, but works best when one end of the strand is directly aligned with a light source. In order to achieve this with an LED strip, I molded and 3D printer custom strand clips. The 3D model that I attached to this retractable hold about 10 strand each and fit the 60 LED meter with silicone case. These clips are printed in two parts to count for overhang print issues. After you determine how many LEDs you plan on utilizing, you can start printing. Once the print is done, you can start sampling. I utilized 19 pixels in the end, so I printed 21 clips to make sure I had enough. Depending on printer's tolerance, the back portion of clips may be tight. I found that pushing them through the backside of clip work best, and used end of lighter to push it through flush. Step 4. Fiber optic clip assembly. The fiber optic assembly is tedious but simple. Start by counting out the first 10 or however many you are using strands. I used about an inch of heat shrink to bind the strands together. The major obstacle with this method is that fiber optic strands are extremely sensitive to temperature. If they get too hot, they will melt and lose some of their transmissive properties. Once the strands are bound, you can insert the group into 3D print clip and shore it with a zip tie. When all the clips are assembled, they can be attached to LED strips. You will need to align each clip to ensure that they are directly over the LEDs. Step 5. Hole for the fiber optic strands. For my build, I laser cut 204 holes into sheet of PET with mirror finish. Then I adhere these to wide foam board and punch these holes through with a pin. Depending on your material, they may be able to use a drill or thick pin to create your holes. Step 6. Finish. Now you can thread the fiber optic strands through the holes. This was time consuming since I had much more strand length than I needed. I secured the strand with hot glue. Again, be warned that fiber optic strands are sensitive to temperature. Hot glue gun I used had a low temperature settings, but even then it still wrapped the strands if they didn't allow the glue to cool. What I ended up doing was apply a bead of glue or glue directly to the backside of hole, wait for the glue to cool, and thread the fiber optic strand through. This wasn't an ideal, so if you have better ideas of how to secure fiber optic strand, doesn't hesitate to add it in the comments. Thank you.